Hey everybody, welcome to an episode of Widgets and Wonders, my show about great products from small companies. Now this week we're going to take a look at some cool new stuff from Top Down Terrain. I've been on the lookout for a while for a solution to be able to run objective room missions without doing tons of work in Infinity ICSs. And Chris from Top Down Terrain has made a really cool product for it. It's super affordable, really easy, packs light too, and packs super easy, so you don't have to have a ton of huge 8x8 buildings that you cart around, and it looks great on the table. So we're going to show you that. He's also done a simpler army transport tray, like a simple one, that goes with all of his laser cut MDF bases, and also fits standard size 28 mil bases as well. Doesn't fit actually the Infinity size bases, but it does fit standard like 40K size 28s, because the difference is, 25s, because it's what is the bottom 25 or is the top 25? Because on a Infinity base, the top is 25 and the bottom is actually bigger than that. So we'll show you that. I got my Toha army actually sitting on right now. I have another one for my upcoming Steel Phalanx army. I'm gonna base all on Chris's awesome MDF bases. Yeah, and we'll show you those. So that's some new stuff from Top Down Terrain. We got a sort of like a tournament army movement tray and a very cool objective room for Infinity ITSs. All right, and here's some of this cool new stuff from Top Down. So first things first, let's talk objective room. So what's slick about this? Well, number one, it's $9.99. You can't really go wrong for 10 bucks for a piece of Infinity Terrain, especially when it's a specialized one like this that's required an objective room mission. So in ITS, there's a number of objective room missions, such as the Armory, you've got Engineering Deck, and a bunch of other ones, which you basically are required to have an 8x8 infinitely tall building in the middle of the table. And it has to have four entrances, and sometimes other things inside of it. Now, it doesn't get used very often in tournaments because, of course, there is a scenery requirement. It makes it hard to do a mission across 10, 20, 30 tables when you gotta build a piece of terrain for each and every one. And this is a great little solution for TOs that want something that's quick and easy to store. It's also a big thing to move, unless you're smart like Chris and make it collapsible. So what this one is, I painted this one up myself. It's just blank MDF when you get it. It's four pieces and then four doors. The doors are all removable because, of course, in the ITS mission, you can actually open all the doors and they sit flat. You can pull the doors out to make them pack flat. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually have these all in a box, a card style box that they live in. And the doors are going to sit inside a little, whatchamacallit, a craft container. So they're all just organized as well. And that's it, ready to rock and roll. So it collapses down. It's this big when collapsed, and you have your 8x8 objective room ready to basically just pop out and go at any event that you want to run. $9.99, super slick, and a great option for running them, because I think they're some of the most interesting missions, because they're all puzzles in Infinity, and I don't think they get played enough. So this is a great option if you're just looking for one for home, or if you're a TO like myself, looking to organize events, and you want a cheap and easy solution. I have six of these now, which is going to make my life way easier running ITSs. I've got this one painted, another one's base coated, and another four more to go. And then those, of course, can be run during my events, which I'm stoked for. So if you're a local guy and you come to my ITS events for Infinity, get ready, practice some room missions. And here's the tournament trays. They are basically designed to be nice, simple, light, easy to transport MDF trays. They do not come painted, of course, they're bare MDF. I've painted these ones up. I sprayed them with a coat of all-purpose black primer, and then I gave them a gloss varnish just to make them a little bit prettier. The inserts I left out and put in afterwards, and they I spray painted and then airbrushed a little bit just to give them some details. So this one's gonna be for my Steel Phalanx. We're gonna be on like poppy white bases. Also available from Top Down Terrain, some of the MDF bases I've already shown off before because they're on all my Yuching guys. And then it also perfectly fits GW size 25s. I believe all of my Toha are on, not Dragonforge, maybe it is Dragonforge, Forgecraft? I don't remember. I used to buy them in bags at Game Castle in San Jose. I don't remember the name of the company. It's either, it's not Dragonforge. I think it's Forgecraft Games. I think it's Forgecraft Games. All of my Necromunda-dudes are on these deck plating bases too. But I panned this up to match, and they perfectly fit into these. So this is ideal to actually transport these guys. Now, interestingly enough, the 25 mil bases for GW stuff, for the most part, are usually 25 at the bottom and then taper slightly to the top. Infinity bases, on the other hand, so here's an Infinity base, they're 25 at the top and taper slightly to the bottom, which means they're more like 26 or 27 at the base. So unfortunately, they don't fit in here. So if you guys are on regular Infinity bases, this might not work for you. If they're on 25s like this, they'll be fine. This is actually the standard size though. So here's some example, here's some silhouette markers. And this is a camo marker from Warsinal. This one's popped up slightly, so it's a little bit warped. These are exactly 25 mil, or they should be, to pop in. And give you an example, so actually, I guess these are not quite exactly 25 mil, but these are exactly 25 mil because this is an actual silhouette. And they fit perfectly in all of these. And of course, if you do buy the MDF bases from Top Down, these are the ones that I have for my my Yu Qing. They fit perfectly into these as well. Oops. It's me putting in an angle, it's making it difficult. And so you can actually display these guys ready to go. So that's why my steel flanks go on this, because it's exactly the right amount and size of bases to display them on. So I'm pretty stoked about that. And yeah, if you're looking for a nice, simple Infinity Army transport option that has bases like that you can just order right alongside it, so you don't want to do any work on the bases either, you can check these out on Top Down as well. And I think you can buy a bag of bases, which is almost exactly enough to fill this sucker out. It's 5 40s, 2 55s, and then I don't remember how many, 2 4 6 8 10 12 14 16 18 22 of the 25 mil bases. So again, it holds most of my Toha stuff because I'm painting my Gorgos, and I don't have remotes, so like, there's not a lot of 40 mil base dudes for Toha at all. I actually ran out of 25s faster than anything else, because that's the thing you get the most of in Toha. And there you go, another Widgets and Wonders on the books. Now, if you know of a great product from a small company you think deserves more attention, you can email me at growminiaturegames@gmail.com or Facebook message me at facebook.com/outofthebasementintothestreets, and I'll put them in front of as many people as possible. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time for another Widgets and Wonders. Till then, I'm Ash. Have a gaming. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to support the channel, of course, like and subscribe and hit the little bell below so you get notifications when I post future content. I do post stuff 7 days a week. My live shows are on Mondays at 2 p.m. Eastern time, typically, unless I notify otherwise. If you want to support the channel further, you can, of course, buy a t-shirt through Spreadshirts, buy a measuring gauge or objective markers from Death Bear Designs, or, of course, most importantly, there is Patreon. Patreon is what makes all this possible, keeps the lights on, pays for the studio costs, pays for the equipment, model costs, and everything else, and most importantly, puts food in my kids' bellies and a roof over their heads. Big thanks to everyone, past, future, who supported me. I do this stuff because of you guys, and, of course, I will continue doing it as long as I can.